This video is about some revision of the equations which is in the syllabus. Okay, FM2 syllabus. Okay, so here we know there are two turbines, impulse and reaction turbine. In impulse turbine we are having Pelton wheel, and in reaction turbine we are having Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine. So these are all the velocity triangles. So this is your velocity V1, it's striking the vane. And it will come out with the relative velocity VR2, and its absolute velocity is V2. Okay, V2's vertical component is VF2 and horizontal component is VW2. So the force acting along the jet direction of motion is rho A, or you can write it as rho Q into VW1 plus VW2. Okay, so work done per second is force into velocity, that is U. So eta H will be VW1 plus VW2 into U divided by GH. When this eta will be maximum is when the velocity of vane is equal to half the velocity of jet, means you will get the maximum efficiency, that is 1 plus cos phi divided by 2. Okay, so this is a reaction turbine. The first one is Francis turbine. In Francis turbine, it will have the radial outward flow. So here VW2 is equal to 0. Outlet will be radial. That is, this is a reaction turbine. And the first one is Francis turbine. For both the reaction turbine, the velocity triangle is the same. There is no difference between them. Here also radial outlet. Here also radial outlet. VW2 is equal to 0. Beta is equal to 90. Here also VW2 is equal to 0. Beta is equal to 90. The only one difference is the discharge, that is your area will be different. Here pi D1 B1 or pi D2 B2 into VF2. Okay, here pi by 4 into D outer diameter the whole square minus diameter of the boss the whole square. Okay, that is the only difference. Work done also will be the same. Work done divided per second is equal to rho Q into VW1 U1. Because VW2 is equal to 0, no. Here rho Q into VW1 plus W2 into U. Here W2 will become 0. So rho Q into VW1 U1. Okay. So here alpha, absolute velocity A. So the angle is alpha. That you have to keep it in mind. Sometimes you might have the confusion here whether it is theta or alpha. Here V1 is nothing but absolute. Absolute means A. So alpha, you have to put alpha here. Okay. The next one is efficiency in turbine and pump. Okay, so as you know, we are generating electric current from the water power. Here the hydraulic energy is converted into mechanical energy, and from that we are connecting the shaft to produce the current electricity. So hydraulic efficiency H, eta H is equal to runner power divided by water power. Mechanical efficiency is shaft power divided by runner power. Overall efficiency is SP divided by WP. Okay. In pump, it's reverse of turbine. Shaft power, impeller power, water power. Here, water power, runner power, shaft power. In pump means shaft power, impeller power, water power. So here, it will have eta mano, WP divided by impeller power. Mechanical efficiency is impeller power divided by shaft power. Overall efficiency is water power divided by shaft power. Okay, the next one is turbine and pump. We are having specific speed. So with the specific speed we can able to tell what will be the type of the turbine. For that purpose only we are finding the specific speed. So specific speed is n into root p divided by h power 5 by 4. P is the kilowatt. You have to substitute power in terms of kilowatt. H is the net heat. What about in pump? Pump, instead of P, as we are getting water, therefore it will be Q. N into root Q divided by H power 3 by 4. H is nothing but manometric head. Q, it has to be in terms of meter cube per second. Okay. In turbine, if the specific speed is less than 10, it is a Pelton wheel. If it is in between 10 to 200 means, then it is a Francis turbine. If it is greater than 200 means, then it is a Kaplan turbine. Okay. So in cavitation also, and you are having both in turbine as well as pump. Thomas cavitation factor sigma is equal to HB minus HS. HB is nothing but barometric head, suction head divided by H. How to find the barometric head? Atmospheric head minus vapor head. H atmosphere minus HV minus HS divided by H. What is the main thing you have to add in terms of pump for finding the Thomas cavitation factor? Is here you have to include a HLS, head loss in the suction pipe. So HB minus HS, you have to include this, minus HLS. Okay, the next is centrifugal pump. Centrifugal pump is the reverse of turbine. Which turbine? Reaction turbine. So here inlet will be radial, therefore here alpha will be 90 degree, VW1 will be 0. Okay, in case of turbine, beta will be 90 degree, VW2 is equal to 0. So in the case of pump, alpha will be 90, VW1 is equal to 0. Okay, so work done will be VW2 U2 divided by G. Okay, here there are four heads. HS is your suction head, delivery head, this is your static head, and this is your manometric head. So static head HS is equal to, it's a sum of suction head plus sum of suction head and delivery head. Manometric head HM is, you can find it by using these three formulas. You have to select, it depends upon the problem. Okay, depends upon the data which is given in the problem. So HM is equal to VW2 U2 divided by G minus losses. If they have mentioned neglect the losses mean, then HM is equal to VW2 U2 divided by G. Okay, or you can find it out by using this formula, HM is equal to HS plus HFS plus HFS plus VD square divided by 2G. This HS means nothing but HS plus HD. Okay, and HM, you can use this formula for finding out. Okay, and minimum speed for the starting. So what is the condition is head due to the pressure rise should be greater than manometric head. Okay, pressure head, that is the rise in the pressure head should be greater than manometric head. With this equation we have derived this formula, N is equal to eta mano into VW2 D2 into 120 divided by pi into D2 square minus D1 square. Okay, this pressure head, rise in pressure head is nothing but U2 square minus U1 square divided by 2G. Must be greater than HM. What is U2? Pi D2 N divided by 60. U1 is pi D1 N divided by 60. If you are doing the calculations, if you are simplifying this, means finally you will get this answer. Okay. Net positive suction head is nothing but atmospheric head minus HS minus HFS minus vapor head. That is net positive suction head. Positive suction head. Okay. And what is the maximum suction lift is? That is the head, that is the pipe maximum height you have to give in for the suction. HS is equal to HA minus HV minus HF minus VS square divided by 2G. Okay, the next is Chezy's equation. You know this Chezy's equation. Q is equal to area into velocity. If you are applying Chezy's equation, is C into root of RS. If it is a Manning's equation, 1 by N R raised to 2 by 3 S raised to half. For the most economical section, if it is a rectangular section, which should be twice the depth, and hydraulic mean depth should be half of the depth. In the case of trapezoidal section, half of the top width should be equal to the length of the side slope. P plus 2ND divided by 2 is equal to D into root of 1 plus N square, and R is equal to D by 2. In the problem, if they given N, you have to use that value, or you have to assume N is equal to 1 by root 3. That is for one vertical, root 3 horizontal. Then your theta will be 60. Okay. The condition for the circular channel, maximum discharge and maximum velocity. Here the theta is 308 degree, here it is 257 degree, and the depth is 0.95 d, and here it is 0.81 d. Okay, this conveyance is nothing but, again, the discharge, Q is equal to K into root S. Here K is the conveyance, it varies, it depends upon the equation what we are using. if we are using Chezy's equation a into c into root rs. So here a into c into root r will be your conveyance if you are using Chezy's equation. If you are using Manning's equation, the conveyance will be 1 by n a r raised to 2 by 3. Okay, what is the unit? Unit is nothing but meter cube per second. The same thing. Because the discharge is meter cube per second, there is no unit for the slope. So the conveyance is also again the discharge. Okay, so the unit is meter cube per second. What is the section factor? The representation is Z. For the critical flow, Z is equal to A into root D. For the uniform flow, Z is equal to A r raised to 2 by 3. Okay. And the next is specific energy. Specific energy, you know the formula, E is equal to Y plus V square divided by 2G. Critical depth, YC is equal to Q square divided by G the whole power 1 by 3. What is Q square? Small Q square is equal to capital Q divided by B. Small Q is equal to capital Q divided by B. What is the critical condition? Q square T divided by G A cube is equal to 1. And minimum energy is 1.5 YC. What about the hydraulic jump? Hydraulic jump, the depth, we call it as a sequent depth or conjugate depth. Okay, sequent depth or conjugate depth. Y2 by Y1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into, if the denominator is 1 means Y1 means, here you have to substitute F1. If the denominator is 2 means, you have to substitute F2. You can change the equation. Y1 by Y2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into root of 1 plus 8 F2 square. Okay. Energy loss delta E is equal to Y2 minus Y1 the whole cube divided by Y4 into Y1 by 2. Okay. And the gravity, gradually varied flow, dy by dx. That is your rise of water level with respect to the channel bottom. That is dy by dx is equal to S0 minus Sf divided by 1 minus q square t divided by ga cube. Or you can write it as, instead of this, you can write the Froude number, 1 minus fr square. Okay. If you want to find out the length of the surface profile. Okay. In that case, delta x is equal to delta e divided by s minus sf bar. What is sf bar? Sf1 plus Sf2 divided by 2. Okay, if they have mentioned if they have mentioned it is a wide rectangular channel, in that case you have to use this formula for finding the dy by dx. Okay, dy by dx is equal to S0 into 1 minus yn divided by y the whole power 3.3 divided by 1 minus yc divided by y the whole power 3. Okay. In some problem, they ask you to find out the slope of water surface with respect to the horizontal. In that case, you have to find SW. Okay, here S0 is the bed slope. dy by dx is the slope of water surface with respect to channel slope. Okay, so if dy by dx, you can find out the dy by dx either by using this formula or by using this formula or by using this formula. If it is wide rectangular channel, you have to use. Okay, in other cases, you can use this equation for finding out dy by dx. If this dy by dx is positive, means the water level is rising. Okay, water level is rising. So, your general formula will be the same. Sw is equal to S0 minus dy by dx. When you have to use this formula, if they have mentioned in the problem to find the slope of water surface with respect to horizontal, that is very, very, very important. If they have given like this, you have to find SW. Otherwise, you can stop it up to dy by dx. Okay. Dy by dx is negative means the water level is falling. In that case, in the general equation, it becomes positive. So, SW is equal to S0 plus dy by dx. Okay. Clear? The next is, in some problem, they ask you to design a lined open channel. In that case, in the syllabus itself, we are having only the trapezoidal section. So, in that case, you have to find the area and perimeter. You have to find the area and perimeter, substitute in this, and you can easily find out. You will get two equations, solve the two equations, and you can find out what is the breadth and what is the depth. Okay. Okay. Next is a model law. We are having only Reynolds model law and a Froude model law. What is the Reynolds model law? Reynolds model is Reynolds model in Reynolds number in the model is equal to prototype. So you'll get rho r vr lr divided by mu r is equal to 1 and their scale ratios. Okay, for the fluid model la fr fluid model in the model will be equal to in the prototype. Here vr is equal to vp by vm is equal to root lr, like that the scale ratios. This is very very important. Okay, time is equal to tr is equal to root lr, acceleration is equal to 1, discharge is equal to lr raised to 2.5, fr is equal to l raised to 3, power is equal to 3.5, torque is equal to lr. Okay, time is equal to root lr, pressure intensity is equal to lr, discharge qr is equal to lr raised to 2.5, force is equal to lr raised to 3, and power is equal to lr raised to 3.5, and torque is equal to lr raised to 4, acceleration is equal to 1. Okay, lr raised to 2.5, 3.5, 4, pressure intensity, discharge, force, power, torque. Okay.